And Jesus spoke to me a while back and said, son, there's some things I want you to say that has been said. Some things have never been said. And then some things you're going to say in a way that has never been said for the people to catch it, because my church is still not functioning in the finished work. We're not functioning as a body in the fullness of the finished work. And then he showed it to me, because we are not finished with our redemption until we function in the ascension. I was taught my whole life that the gospel was the death, the burial, and the resurrection. And it is. And it is. But it's just not all of it. Because Jesus is not dead. He ain't buried. He ain't even just resurrected. The last thing he did was ascend to the right hand of God and sit down. And he says, that's the dimension that you and I were created to live in. That my salvation ain't complete until I reach the ascension. Because that's when he finished it, when he sat down. Not just when he came out the grave, but when he ascended and sat down. Down at the right hand of God, I believe he crossed his legs just to say, I am done. And this is the dimension that you and I are supposed to be living in, a finished, completed dimension. I came to announce to you that after this weekend, you ready to receive this? The struggle is over. The striving is done. My God. Oh, my goodness. You got to hear me. God is about to shift you into a dimension where you're not trying to get it done. You're going to act like it's already done. What is this ascension dimension? It is the dimension of total complete dominion. Ooh. It is the dimension where you don't strive for anything. It is the dimension where Satan is more concerned about what you're going to do to him than you are concerned about what he's going to do to you. It is the dimension where you put the crown on and you begin to reign like the king that you really are. This is the dimension that we have left out of our Christian faith. And this is what Paul is praying for the church at Ephesus. I'm trying to teach this, but I feel something trying to make me scream. This is the dimension that Paul is praying. He says, after I heard of your faith and after I heard you receive the gospel and we came in there and we laid the foundation, he says, I've been praying without ceasing for you. Why? That God would give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. In the knowledge of him. This is the same prayer that Paul needs to be praying and praying and praying, and we need to be praying and praying and praying over the church and the believers now, that your salvation does not end when you get saved. That is not the end of it. That is the beginning of it. That is just the door to get you into the room so that now you can experience what Paul is praying for. He says, in other words, if I were to say it the way Paul, if he would say it the way I would have said it, I would have said that the moment I heard you got saved, I've been praying and praying and praying for you that you don't stop there. That you don't just be satisfied to have the new birth and to be born again, except we're going to get into that a little bit deeper because sometimes I'm not aware that we fully know what happened to us when we got born again. But he says, I'm praying that you don't stop. I'm praying that you don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop. Look at somebody say, don't stop. 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 Why? Why? Because he says, when you get over into Ephesians chapter number 3, he says, I've been praying that you might know all the fullness of God. And then he says, I've been praying that you would be rooted and grounded in love so that you can comprehend what all the saints, what is the width, the length, the depth, the height, the width, the length, the depth, the height, the width, the length, the depth, the height. I was reading that one day and God said, you know what those are, right? I say, yes, they're dimensions. They're dimensions. That's what he was saying. They're dimensions in me. They're dimensions in me. There's dimensions in me. And Paul is saying we can't stop until we search and measure and delve into all these dimensions. Anybody want to know how deep we can go? How wide we can go? How high we can go? We just getting started. There is so much more. And this is why I'm here, because I have found my family. I have found some people who are not satisfied with just a little dip in the pool. No, we ready to dive all the way down and put our scuba gear on and just see how deep we can go.